I've been refactoring and improving old code, I came across a foolish mistake. So for some reason, past me was adding interpolation on the other players and decided to even out the playing field. The other clients would be 100 milliseconds behind due to the interpolation, so wouldn't it only be fair for the local player to be as well? Basically, I added in a 100 millisecond delay to all inputs on the local player. After 4 days of searching for why there's input lag, I found that code and removed it. Even with this, the movement was jittery, and because it takes time for packets to be sent to the server and back to the client, there was still a slight delay between your inputs and when you would actually start moving. There is a solution to this called client-side prediction. It would take me a while to describe exactly how prediction works, but it basically simulates what your movement would be on the server and then corrects based off the packets received by the server. Now that I've implemented this prediction, my movement is silky smooth and responsive, even when testing with people from Canada. On the topic of Canada, I continued working on replacing the asset models in my game. The Glock model is basically finished and I fixed all the shading issues, as well as added a few small details. I also made this M1911 model on stream. Which, by the way, if you don't want to miss out on streams or videos, you could make sure to hit subscribe, which is right below the like button. After streaming, I started working on some simple changes to improve the feeling of the game. These changes include smoothing out the footsteps, adding bullet casings, and making them bouncy. And that's when all of a sudden something terrible happened. My Wi-Fi decided to commit die, so I had to work offline. I began to brainstorm some things that I could work on without Stack Overflow. And so I decided to make a laser using Albert Einstein's theory of relativity. I got the lasers working perfectly. Somewhat. Well, anyways, I found what was causing the issue and fixed it. Also, someone made me some sounds that I could use, and they were surprisingly good. I implemented them, and it brought a much more powerful feeling to the weapon. And that was when my internet came back from the dead. Now, what was the first thing I did? Well, open YouTube, of course. Dani had a new video and it gave me an idea. I've been wanting to make cars in Callout for a while, but it seemed too difficult. Dani gave all the resources needed, so I hippity-hoppitied his stolen code, and then there was only one issue I still had to iron out. It did not work in any way, shape, or form. After following similar steps as Dani, I got the car working a lot better. But the model wasn't good for testing, because, you know, cars aren't really boxes anymore. I tried modeling a car, but it ended up looking a bit sus. I'll revisit car modeling in the future, perhaps in a stream, but for now, an asset will do. The car was starting to feel better, but it drifted way too much. To figure out how to solve this issue, I used a very helpful resource. GTA 5! They basically perfected the car controller, so I tested. I fixed the driftiness by helping the steering, adjusting the wheels' torques to their forward slips, and by adding downforce. While I was testing, the camera controller didn't really have the controller aspect. So since I was already at it, I added a GTA camera controller. As well as a cinematic one, a hood camera, the automatic one, and even a helicopter camera just for fun. My next task was to put this car controller in Callout. Tom Weiland, the genius who made the current networking solution that I use, has outdone himself and made his new solution Riptide. It's not public yet, but thankfully I was one of the selected testers. and so I made an empty client and server project for the car controller only. After learning the ins and outs of this new solution, which is very similar to his current public networking series, I copied some code over and got the car controller working in multiplayer. The only issue that there still was horrendous jitter, which can be solved by the same client-side prediction and reconciling on the client, but I haven't gotten to that yet. What I am currently working on as this devlog is released is changing Callout's multiplayer to run on this new solution, Riptide. That way, I can port the cars into Callout and implement the ability to get in and out of the vehicles. Thankfully, I made the car system very modular so I can define any amount of axles, which ones brake, the axles which are motors, and which should steer. To finish up the car controller, I added drift marks and some god-awful sounds. Anyways, that's what I've been up to since last devlog. If you'd like to try the car controller out for yourself, I'll put a link to the single player version in the description. Hit the subscribe button at your own risk. Thank you for watching, and see you all next time.